back by popular demand. I don't know if it was actually by any demand at all, but we're going to do it anyway. This is Teamsday. We run through the team lists with a bit of a Warriors Anonymous twist. Jared Cronin, Isaac Soss, and Monita Soss joining you for this one as we head in towards game day, Friday night, up against the St. George Dragons. So first of all, the starting lineup for our opponents, the St. George Illawarra Dragons. And there it is right there. Okay, cool. Now, boys, on to our lads. Chance is in charge of our saves and our tries. Here he goes, number one. Number two, Isaac came up with this one after the mullet was flowing last week.
You can't hunt what you can't kill.
And there's Jean-Claude Van Damme on. Well, the Rocco gets the rock on, I guess. But didn't quite sound right, but that's all good. On the right-hand side, so the boys are going to be cooking, hopefully. We'll see what happens. We've got the RTS, the reverse caterpillar. We're still trying to figure out how he managed to pull off that manoeuvre. Hopefully he's, gets the hands on this week.
You boys fly girls.
That's all right. Marcelo Montoya, Eminem, the Matador, whatever you want to call him. All right, into the halves. We've had to come up with a new flavour combo. It was pointed out that the cheese is obviously Brandon Smith, so this week our halves combo was bacon and egg. Delicious. And Te Maere Martin is the egg. And of course, Sean Johnson is the bacon.
Hot and oily.
Okay, that sounds a bit strange.
Okay. It's all good.
Whoa.
And into the front row, Adam, yours. Someone else want to tackle him because people don't generally want to. Number nine is Wade Magneto Egan. Threw one of our viewers last week and they couldn't figure out who the hell Wade was for quite a while. Also partnering him in the front row is our 150th match celebrant. Bam Bam Barnett, been playing really well too. Followed up by the Ford Hybrid, number 11. We'll see how many minutes he might get this week. Interesting to see with the bench as well. Number 12, Chair Capel. He's back. Capois, whatever you want to call him. He's a good man, playing on that right edge. And the Captain Fantastic, of course. New hairstyle this week. He was kind of getting to that territory last week, I thought, with the hair coming out. I was like, I need to do something.
I commented on that on the Christian Catley's podcast. And they had a bit of the Babysitter's Club going on.
Chanel number 14 smells good on the bench. And then we've got obviously a new one for Tomale.
Hey, that's me, Tomale.
Number 16 this week is Jake the Mus Laban. Looking for a big game from the young fella. And also, interestingly, normally the 18th man, he's in the number 17 jumper. Adam,
I wonder.
Pompey. The POMP. I don't know what you heard about him, but he's number 17. The 18th man is Zion Mai'u, which is interesting as well. Probably something for us fellas to have a little chat about. Boys. First of all, we'll start with you, Moneta. What do you think the advantages and the continuity in most of the team being the same as last week?
I think the obvious is that they're getting used to each other. They've now developed into, understanding how each other plays and that will only carry forward in terms of improvement. And so I reckon you'll expect to see more improvement this weekend. And hopefully it's not wet weather. That's what I'm thinking. So, yes. So the starting lineup looks good. Just hoping it's not wet weather.
Yeah. I think you might not be getting your wish there. Let's just check the weather forecast as you are having a chat. And it looks like it's going to be a little bit wet, but we'll see.
Come on, Jim Hickey, shit.
I know, right? That rain cloud, it's like the cartoon, eh? Sort of the rain cloud just follows us.
Bloody
Now, Isaac, interestingly, I found on the bench, we spoke about the POMP being in the 17, which is an interesting call. Do you think that he will stay there by the time we get down to cut down, what will it be, Thursday night, when they, you know, narrow the team down to the actual squad, do you think maybe Zion might get bumped up onto the bench for a debut, perhaps?
Yep, that's what I reckon. I reckon the lion named Zion will get a spot on the bench. I reckon maybe naming Pompey just to take a little bit of pressure off Zion throughout the course of the week. And as the game gets closer, I mean, the day before, on the day, change it up. Zion, you know it all along. You're going to be in the 17. I reckon that's what's going to happen.
Yeah, nice. Just to maybe they're just kind of easing the pressure a little bit on them. And I know that they like to do a little bit of juggling around as well on that 24-hour cut down. It's almost like we need to do an extra episode on that 24 hours because, you know, things kind of just get flipped upside down a little bit. Moneta, we're coming back from a performance which wasn't our best last week. How are we feeling about this squad looking to just rectify things on the road?
I think actually the weird thing in last year happened, we were actually better away than we were playing at home. We won most of our games away. It must be something about the pressure of playing at home. But I think we'll do better. I reckon we'll see a bit more improvement. And I think that was our first proper wet weather game. And so I think now we can acclimatise to potentially if it is wet over against St. George.
Yeah, nice. Isaac, who in our team do you think, not really under selection pressure, shall we say, but who would be, you know, feeling their most self-driven pressure this week in the team?
Okay, probably toss up between two players. I'd go RTS and then Ford Focus. Oh, sorry.
That's a good one. Ford Focus.
Old Ford Focus. He was more Ford Fiesta than last week.
I guess you could say he can't afford to drop the ball.
Oi, oi, oi.
Needs to put a bit of 95 premium in the engine for Jackson Ford. He's going to want to make up for those mistakes, right?
Yeah.
He's going to want to make up for those three drop balls. Again, weather conditions, Buddha called it. You know, he had some pretty tough passes, but he's got some pretty high standards now. Especially considering the week before, he was flawless, I thought. The week before, no mistakes, and was just deadly. And RTS, obviously, he's got some pretty lofty standards for himself too, you know, a former Daly M. So, yeah, I think those two will probably come out with a point to prove.
Yeah, nice. Moneta, what do you think is going to be coming at us from the Dragoons side? We need Dede Whatakura here to throw out inappropriate nicknames for them.
The Drag. They actually played okay. They actually played pretty good on the weekend against the Tigers, and Zach Lomax looked like he had a fight lit up his ass, considering all the kind of commotion over him leaving the Dragons. But I do think we're a much better team compared to the Tigers, and I think they'll experience a bit more difficulty against us being the Warriors. And
My one concern, though, is they have got a pretty experienced forward pack. Like, if you have a look at their bench, with the people on that bench there and how many games they've got, Jack DeBellin's got 200 under his belt, Blake Laurie and Ben Murdoch-Masilla, I'm pretty sure, have got more than 100, 150 games each. And then you've got us. You've got Laban, who's got two games to his name. Ale, who's got, maybe a handful, maybe pushing 20.
Yeah,
games.
But I think our form going, and even though we played pretty badly, and we still got a draw, you know, taking that into a positive, I think we can only go up after that. It was a pretty, when I reflect on it, it was a pretty bad game we had. So I'm hoping, and me being positive, that our structures and our lessons learned from the previous game, we can, you know, definitely take the Dragons to the sword.
See what you did there. See what you did there, Mother of Dragons.
You can say Jackson Ford is looking forward to the game too. So, sorry, enough.
He will be too. He really will be.
Hunt-a-thon tonight.
Sorry. <Good. about>
Dad joke central. Isaac, just before we jump out of here, bro, quickly, Where does this game get won and lost for us?
Forward battle. I mean, Manly showed that we might be a bit susceptible with their post-contact metres gained. I think St. George will probably aim up the same way. I mean, they don't have the same sort of forward pack as Manly, but they've got some pretty experienced heads in that team. So they'll probably aim to go there. But if we can shut them down and shut them down quickly, getting a roll on and PCMs, I think we'll probably quickly put them out of the game. My only, my other concern is Ben Hunt. You know, he's a pretty mercurial player. He can turn a game on its head. And if he decides to show up and show up hard, he could cause some problems. And Zach Lomax too, on the back of getting a new contract with the Eels. But the way he's playing at the moment, he's moved into centre now, in one from the wing.
Okay.
So he might be a bit of a target in the air as well. I'm not quite sure whose side of the field he's going to be on against. But it'll be an interesting matchup either way.
Might be him versus Roger, perhaps. Mm. So I think Sully normally plays on the left for them.
There you go.
That's a ding-dong battle right there. Moneta, a quick score prediction, my man?
Ooh, I will go 24-12 to the Warriors. Just judging on the conditions that could be potentially coming up.
I'm going to stick with that 12-point margin. I'll go 30-18 to us. Ooh. Isaac?
I'm going to go 18-6.
Ooh.
18-6 in the wet.
Yep.
Yeah. Let's get it. All right, boys. Thanks very much for joining us on Team Day. Team lists with a twist. And we will see how we get on. Good luck for Friday. Up the Waz. Go, the Warriors.